Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel, and welcome back to another one of my Empties videos. So it's my first Empties video in the year of 2020, which is something I'm super duper excited about, because these are Empties which I have been collecting since a while, and it's finally time for me to show you all of them. So hopefully I'm able to show you all of them in this video only, and I'm sorry this video is a little bit extra bright. Like, my face looks like really really bright for some reason. I don't know why. Even my background and everything, it just looks super clear and extra super bright. I don't know what is up with the settings, but we will try to ignore that and focus on all of this garbage right here, and I will tell you what I like, what I did not like, my recommendations, and all of that stuff. So yeah, without any further ado, let's get started, and I will show you guys everything. So quickly, I want to mention the Clinique Moisture Surge, which I filmed a dedicated video all about it. I told you if I think it's worth the hype or not. You should definitely go and check out that video. I will leave a link in the description box just in case you haven't watched it already. You can go ahead and check it out. Will I repurchase this? No, because I have found other gel moisturizers which are a lot more inexpensive and which do a similar job. The Pond's one is one of my absolute favorites. That is one I would probably actually end up repurchasing, not that I need to right now, because I do have a lot of it yet and I am nowhere near finishing it up. But after I finish that up, I will probably, like, that is a moisturizer I see myself buying again and again because of how inexpensive it is. But this is something that is so expensive that I can't even think about repurchasing it. But yeah, it is a good product. It's just not worth the money in my personal opinion. So yeah, that was about this one. Moving on, next we actually have a couple of chargers. So wait, I found two. Yeah, I think for today's video we just have two. So first I'll talk about this one, which I used up earlier. This is the it's by the brand Enlivin. So this is a brand which I found it at Beautiful, which is this cosmetics and like beauty supply store in Lokhandwala, very close to my house. So I got this one from there. It's the raspberry and red apple shower gel. First of all, this smells absolutely freakingly amazing. The reason I got this was the scent and nothing else. I love the smell of green apples, raspberry. It's all very nice and fruity and all of that. So that's mainly the reason why I got this, and it smells absolutely amazing in the shower. It also cleans your body really really well. If I go back to Beautiful and I see this once again, it was pretty inexpensive I believe. So yeah, if I go ahead and I see this again on Beautiful, then I will definitely repurchase this. But not something that I'm specifically I feel chargers are something which if it cleans the body really well and if it's really nice and smells good, then I will repurchase it. But I'm not very particular and specifically picky. Like, I don't have a favorite shower gel as such. Talking about that, I do actually have not really a favorite kind of a shower gel, but yeah, it's definitely one of my top picks. So let's talk about that. That is the Plum Vanilla and Fig body wash. This one is called a body wash shower gel, whatever. So this particular one is one that personally I think if I had to go out and repurchase, this is something I see myself going back and repurchasing every winter specifically, because this is definitely a more moisturizing kind of a shower gel. The scent is something very winter specific to me. I relate it with winters. It's not something I would use in the summers because I think it's too sweet, too vanilla, too warm to use in the summers or in the monsoon season. But in the winters, I would definitely love to repurchase this. Also, I'm someone who does not use body lotion. Like, no matter how much I try, no matter if I make it a resolution or a goal, I just can't get myself to use body lotion on a regular basis, because A, I don't like feeling very sticky. I like to feel normal and very non-sticky, and normally no matter how well a body lotion gets absorbed into the skin, you can still feel like the body lotion on you, and that's something I don't really like. I'm also very lazy. When I take a shower and I get out, I wear my lenses, I do my skincare routine, maybe throw on some makeup, of course get dressed, and then I will just go ahead with my day, have breakfast, have coffee, blah blah blah, and then run out of the door. But I'm not someone who has the patience to actually like dedicate a good 5-10 minutes to actually put on body lotion all over my hands and my legs and my chest and blah blah blah. I don't have that kind of time or dedication, or I just can't get myself to do that. So personally for me, body washes like this are really great because these are more of like moisturizing sort of body washes. So my skin does not feel dry because I'm using this. So normally my skin does really get very, very dry in the winters. In the summers and monsoons, it's perfectly fine, but it does get a little bit dry in the winters. But this winter, I didn't really feel my skin getting that dry because I was using this, and I felt like it did make a difference in some sort of way. It was probably maybe in my head, but I just did not feel as dry as I normally do feel in winters. And normally, otherwise in winters, sometimes I do tend to use body lotion on certain days, maybe in the night when my hands or my legs are feeling particularly dry. But this time I didn't really feel that happen at all. And all thanks to this, because I definitely feel like it made a difference. I currently have the other variant, which is the creme caramel one, in my shower right now. And I feel like that one is also pretty similar, but I do really like the scent of this one more compared to that one. So I definitely see myself repurchasing this one next year in the winters. I feel like for this winter, that one is going to last good enough. And then when we get back with the summers and the monsoons, I will use a shower gel like this, probably like more of a gel refreshing kind of a one and not really a moisturizing one. But then again, when we come with, when winters start again, like maybe in October, November-ish, I think then I'll go ahead and repurchase this one, because I think it's something I'm going to definitely look forward to every winter, is using a nice moisturizing shower gel. So that's the reason I would particularly recommend this one. And if you're someone who has dry skin like throughout the year, I would definitely highly suggest and recommend that you try this one, because I personally think it made a difference for me and it might make a difference for you as well. So you should definitely check that one out if you have particularly dry skin. And I feel like I've been talking about that for a while. Talking about body lotion, even though, again, like I mentioned, I'm not really a body lotion person, but this is one that I did empty. So I actually used pretty much all of this last year, but then I had like little bit left. And again, like I mentioned, I'm not a body lotion person at all. So I don't tend to use body lotion pretty much throughout the year. But then when it's winters and my skin gets comparatively a little bit more dry, I do tend to use body lotion sometimes. So the remainder, the little bit that was left, I did use up now, finally. And this is the Dove Go Fresh body lotion. This is the green tea and cucumber one. So I do really like the scent of this one. And Dove body lotions, I feel like I can still use because they are not as thick and heavy and greasy, and they do get absorbed pretty quickly into the skin as compared to, I feel like, other body lotions. So that's the reason I do really like this one. So yeah, if I do go ahead and repurchase a body lotion, maybe just because I'm feeling a little extra dry and sometimes, and you just want to have it on hand just in case you need some, then I think I will probably go ahead and repurchase this one in specific, because I really like the scent and I also like the formulation of the Dove body lotions in general. So I'll probably go ahead and repurchase this if I need one. And again, it's more on the inexpensive side, so yeah, even if I don't use it, I won't feel as bad about it. But then I really don't feel bad about not using body lotions, because I can give them to my mom and she like flies through body lotions. She has really, really dry skin and she uses them like pretty much every single day for like 365 days. I don't know how she has that kind of dedication to do it, but I don't. So yeah, all my body lotions go to her, and I know that they're not going to go to waste. They're definitely going to be used up pretty well. Moving on, next we have some shampoos to talk about. I have three shampoos, I believe. Yes, I do have four actually. I have four shampoos to talk about. The first one is this one. I've spoken about this a couple of times. This is the Avon Advanced Techniques Anti-Dandruff 2-in-1 Shampoo and Conditioner. So I don't really have a flaky scalp, but sometimes my scalp can get flaky and a little bit more on the drier side. And that's when I will use this. And it's more of like a moisturizing formulation when it comes to shampoos. If my hair is feeling really dry or my scalp is feeling really dry, that's when I will use this. I've used this a couple of times. It's one of my favorite holy grails. Always have to have this on backup. I have one in my shower right now, and then I have a couple of backups already. And whenever this comes in some kind of offer, I definitely do replenish my stock. So yeah, this is one that you will continue seeing in my empties. Definitely one I would repurchase and highly recommend as well. Then we also have the Biotique Bio Green Apple fresh a daily purifying shampoo and conditioner for oily hair and scalp. So this is more of like a mild shampoo and conditioner. So if you shampoo your hair very regularly, this is one I would recommend because it's not going to really dry out your hair a lot. So when I have to wash my hair every day or like every other day, I never wash my hair every single day. Like I will never wash my hair like 2 days in a row ever. But if I have to wash my hair for some reason every other day because maybe I have an event coming up, or maybe I'm going somewhere out, or maybe I'm traveling, something of that sort, I will use something like this. I do have the big daddy size bottle. It is the 800ml bottle, I believe. So yeah, I have repurchased that already. And once I run out of that, I will probably repurchase it again as well, because I do believe it is, I mean, I do like that shampoo. So yeah, that was that. Already repurchased this one. Then moving on next to this is the Tresemme Hair Fall Defense Pro Collection Shampoo. So earlier they had the regular ones, and now they've come up with this Pro Collection sort of thing, which is supposed to be better of some sort. So yeah, I do really like this one as well. It's one of my favorite shampoos, and I do believe I have one bottle right now as well already. I think it's the same size as well. But I also have the Dove shampoos, and I'm going to talk about them, one of them, in a bit. So yeah, I kind of switched between the Dove ones and the Tresemme ones. But yeah, the Tresemme hair fall shampoo is one of my favorites, because back in the day when I had a lot of hair fall issues, none of the other shampoos were working. This was the only one that actually worked for me and helped me with my hair fall. So as long as it continues to work for my hair, I will definitely keep repurchasing this every once in a while. And also, these are a very good... you get a very good quantity for the amount that you're paying, like the money you're paying. And then you also get a lot, like in regular supermarkets, if you go to like Big Bazaar or Food Bazaar or something like that, you also have very good offers on this. So it makes it like an even better deal. So yeah, I'm not really very particular about shampoos as such. I do have a lot of different ones, because I've heard that if you just use one shampoo constantly, your hair kind of gets used to it and then kind of stops working. So yeah, that's the reason why I like to have a couple of different options, and depending on how my hair is feeling and all of that, I keep switching between them. Last but not the least, we have the Dove Intense Repair Shampoo. So this one is supposed to be for damaged hair. So again, it's not like a super moisturizing formulation, but it kind of repairs your hair, makes it really, really soft. Now this one, I actually have a small story to talk about. So I have spoken a couple of times about my trip that I went to recently. So I met one of these guys who actually uses the exact same shampoo. So there we did not really get to wash our hair as much. So when we were on the trek, like in the mountains, we were not able to like take a shower or wash our hair or something like that, and it just felt so disgusting that we were just craving to go back to like a hotel and be able to take like a good long shower and really cleanse ourselves and cleanse our body, cleanse our hair and all of that. And when we were having one of these discussions, one of the guys mentioned that he actually uses this shampoo and it makes his hair super nice and super soft and all of that. And that is when I realized that even though Dove is supposed to be like a brand and a product that always advertises females, but it's also something that guys use. And when he mentioned how this is his holy grail shampoo, I was just like, oh my god, I use the exact same thing. So yeah, that just made me realize that maybe if the reason why I'm talking about all of this is because if you have a guy in your life, maybe your best friend, your brother, your boyfriend, whoever it is, and if he's looking for a good shampoo, something to make his hair soft and smooth and all nice, then I think this is something you should definitely get him. Like, you can get him this, or you can ask him to get it for himself or something like that, because I do have a friend who loves this and uses this and it works for him. So I'm guessing it works for like all guys. So yeah, you can definitely try it out yourself. And also, if there's a guy in your life who's looking for it, you can definitely get it for him as well. So yeah, something that's very unisex. I feel like I talk about, since I'm a girl, I'm always talking about stuff that will work for other girls out there. Yeah, this is the first time I had like a unisex favorite to mention. So yeah, a special shout out and special mention for that. Anyways, moving on, next we have some dry shampoos. I have two of the collab dry shampoos. I have the fruity one and I have the tropical one. So, personally, I don't want to sound biased, but personally, I'm not as fond of collab dry shampoos as much as I love my Batiste. So Batiste Divine and Dark is like my absolute favorite because I don't have to leave it overnight in my hair, and it's got like this color already, so it does not really leave any white residue. So that is like my absolute favorite, but I definitely think that Batiste dry shampoos feel a lot more cleaner and absorb a lot more oil that is in your hair compared to these ones. These I feel like did not leave my hair feeling as clean as Batiste does, which is probably why I will use the ones that I have left. But then when it comes to repurchasing, I don't really think I will repurchase the collab ones. I think I'll go back to my tried and true and trusty Batiste. So yeah, that was that. Moving on, next we have some moisturizers. Yeah, we have a couple of moisturizers. We have the Clinique ID. So I got the blue cartridge with the dramatically different oil control gel, and like you can see, I have tried my best to use as much as possible. And again, just like I mentioned about Moisture Surge, I would also like to mention about this one that I do feel like it is a good product, but it's not something I would go ahead and spend my money on because I don't feel like I saw some dramatically different results. I feel like my affordable moisturizers do just as good of a job. So I don't know why I should spend so much money on this specific product if I can get something exact, I mean, not exactly the same, but something very, very similar and some pretty good, I mean, pretty similar results if I can get at a much cheaper price. And I don't know why I should spend so much of money. So I think that's the reason I would not repurchase this one. So yeah, that was that. Talking about some things which I would probably go ahead and repurchase, Neutrogena Hydro Boost Gel. Again, I feel like this is again very, very similar to the Pond's moisturizer that I spoke about in that Clinique video. So again, you can definitely refer to that video, but yeah, that Pond's moisturizer I feel like is just as good. This is around 800-850. How much is this? Yeah, 850 bucks, 849. And that one was around, I think, 150-200, like something of that sort. So again, that's still like 25% of the cost of this. So I feel like it's definitely a much better deal to go ahead and spend on that rather than spend on this. So again, I think I would stick with that one, but yeah, I don't think I would specifically repurchase this one because I have that. So yeah, those were my thoughts on this. But it was an absolutely, I'm sorry I dropped a couple of things which are kept right on the floor. But yeah, I still think it's an amazing, amazing, amazing product. I absolutely freakingly love it. But it's just that I have something much more affordable, which is why I don't think I would repurchase that. But I also have the Plum Green Hue Renew Clarity Night Gel. This is my favorite moisturizer when my skin is covered with pimples and acne, especially during that time of the month. And this is something that I would probably go ahead and repurchase. I don't have a backup right now, but yeah, the next time I place an order on Plum, I think I'll probably get a backup of this one as well, because yeah, it's just one of my favorite moisturizers for some not very good days. So yeah, definitely would repurchase that and recommend that as well. I have a video, it's a nighttime skincare routine video which has like 1,000, I mean, it's got thousands of views, and it's majorly because of this product, which is why that video is like super duper special to me, and the product itself is super duper special to me, because that is, I think, one of the first videos on my channel which really, really blew up and which has like a lot of views. So yeah, that product is just very, very special to me. So yeah, that is something which I also wanted to just quickly mention. Moving on, next let's talk about some face washes. Yeah, we just have two. I have the Blossom Kochar Aroma Magic Activated Bamboo Charcoal Face Wash. So this one is more of like a mild charcoal cleanser, but yeah, I don't think this one was that impressive. I love my Avon Charcoal Face Wash a lot more than I love any other charcoal face wash, apart from the Tricone one as well. I do like the Tricone one as well, but yeah, those are my favorites when it comes to charcoal face washes, and this one came nowhere close. So it was like an okayish product, but not really again a favorite, because I don't think it does a good enough job of taking care of like getting rid of all of the makeup, and like even everyday makeup, this doesn't do that good of a job in removing everything. You have to go in with a micellar water for sure, otherwise you'll probably wake up with pimples the next day. So yeah, that's the reason why I don't think I would repurchase this. It's not really much of a favorite. Then I also have the VLCC Melia Face Wash, which is meant for normal to oily skin. Again, like an okayish cleanser, but not really something super duper blown away by or something like that. So yeah, I don't think I would repurchase this one either. So yeah, that was that. Moving on, we have a sunscreen. I have the Miniso UV non-irritating and breathable SPF 25 PA double plus whitening sunscreen sun protector. So this was my travel sunscreen, but I do not like the fact that this can really mess up a lot in your like travel pouch or whatever you're basically going to carry this in, because it's leaked quite a bit on me. I do like the formulation and the consistency, but the packaging, or I don't know, something about the product just really gets messy every single time. Always leaks, and I've lost quite a bit of product like that as well. So yeah, I won't repurchase this. Maybe I'll just buy like a smaller Lotus or Lakme sunscreen and use that to travel with, but I won't travel with this because I don't want to mess up my like all the other stuff that I'm carrying as well every single time. So yeah, I've not had the best experiences with this one, to be very honest. But the product in general, like the sunscreen, is very nice. But if you're looking to buy this for like normal use, then I would recommend it. If you're looking to travel with it, because it's a very thin, small container, then for that, I won't really recommend it, because personally, I've not had very good experiences. Moving on, next, I have the Miss Claire Professional Makeup Primer, the green one. One of my absolute favorite primers, definitely recommend it. I love the way this looks on the skin, just smooths and blurs out my skin. My skin looks flawless when I'm wearing this, which is why I absolutely love it. And I would highly recommend it. I also have the Biotique Bio White Advanced Fairness Treatment. Like, it's basically like supposed to be a fairness cream sort of a thing. I don't see any fairness. I don't believe in it. I don't see any brightening, whitening. I don't see any results. It's just like a regular moisturizer. Pretty okay-ish. Wouldn't recommend it either. What else do we have? Then I have the Celon CS Dazzling Snow Serum. This is supposed to be their... it's kind of like a vitamin C serum, I believe. Yeah. It's kind of like a vitamin C serum. Did really like it, but would not really go ahead repurchasing or recommend it, because I do have, again, a lot of other much better options out there. And I will be doing a dedicated vitamin C serum specific video, so definitely stay tuned for that one. Of course, you need to subscribe, hit on the bell, so that way you get in every single time I post a new video, and when that particular video goes live, you will get to know. Shameless plug. So yeah, this one, again, I wouldn't repurchase or highly recommend, because there are a lot other better options out there. So yeah, was that. And then I have the PAC Retro Matte Gloss and Shade Teddy Bear. This is literally my favorite liquid lipstick ever, my favorite lipstick ever. Shade is absolutely amazing, the formulation is absolutely amazing. I have raved about this for like, I don't even remember how long at this point. It's absolutely empty. I'm going to toss this away. Wouldn't repurchase it immediately, but yeah, I will go ahead and repurchase it eventually. Hopefully PAC never ever discontinues the shade. Hopefully, and I don't want to jinx it. I don't even want to say it, because I think I'll jinx it, but then I've said it now. I hope I don't jinx it myself. But yeah, absolutely freakingly love this lipstick. I would highly recommend it. If you are around my skin tone, I think it's going to be a pretty good nude for you. If you're a little bit darker than me, I think it will still work for you. But if you're like really dark compared to my skin tone, I don't want to sound racist when I say this, but yeah, if you're really dark as compared to me, then I'm not sure if this particular shade will work for you. But then I do believe they have some more shades, like they have a huge shade range, so you'll definitely find a good nude shade. And even if you're looking for maybe like brighter, bolder shades as well, you'll definitely find a lot of shades that they have. So yeah, you can definitely go to like a store or check online swatches on other people and pick out a shade for you. So that was that. But yeah, the Retro Matte Gloss formulation in general is literally one of my absolute favorites. I'm wearing Soza right now as well, which is another shade from them. And then I have this perfume as well. So this is just one part. So basically, I have this perfume which has like two sides. I finished up one side, I still have the other side. This is the Avon Eve Do It perfume. So this is the split the name as one side is like DU and the other side is ET. So I believe this side is ET. And yeah, this was a pretty good everyday fragrance as well. Did not really last super duper long on the skin, and it was not really a scent that I loved so much I would go ahead and repurchase it. So yeah, it was pretty okay-ish. yeah, still working on finishing up the other side. And yeah, that is pretty much it. That is all of my empties. My bin in which I store my empties is absolutely empty right now. So yeah, those were all of my empties. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video, and I hope it was not super duper long, even though it is like pretty much almost 25 minutes long. So I'm not gonna make it any further longer. Definitely again, please do subscribe and hit the bell button, because that way you'll get them every single time I post a new video. It would really mean a lot to me if you would support my channel like that. And yeah, that is pretty much it. I will quickly sign off now. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, bye bye.